Hi, I'm Tyler Dawson. I'm the deputy editor of the editorial pages at the Ottawa Citizen, and this is Kady O'Malley. She writes about politics for the Ottawa Citizen. And the big news in Ottawa this week is that a chunk of the street fell through the ground, but on the hill, we have quite other things planned. And this week, the big news was assisted dying.
Yeah, as it turns out, the assisted dying bill, which was, of course, supposed to be passed by June 6th, missed that deadline. Now in the Senate, where we're getting our first sense of how this newly independent Senate is going to work. And I think it's been a bit of a surprise to pretty much everyone who's watching, particularly the government, who are, I think, hoping that the bill would make it through with fairly minor changes. Instead, the Senate has decided to make some very significant changes to the bill. That means it's going to then have to be referred back to the House of Commons for concurrence. If they don't agree with the amendments, and so far it sounds like there's not a lot of enthusiasm, that bounces back to the Senate, and it sets off something that we've never really seen in modern Canadian political history, which is sort of a showdown between the two chambers over what should happen to a bill.
And we can expect that to shake out over the next several days to a week, right?
Absolutely. I would be very surprised if there's any resolution by before, say, next Wednesday or Thursday, simply because the Senate is taking a very exhaustive look at the bill. They've already passed one very significant amendment. There's more expected, and they're going to want to send that back to the House probably early next week, and who knows how long it takes. We're in sort of weirdly unprecedented territory here, simply because no one can recall a situation where you had so much independence in the Senate versus a majority house in the majority government in the House. So, who knows is the answer.
Thanks for watching. This has been This Week in Politics on the Hill. For more on this, follow along at ottawacitizen.com.